Alright guys, welcome back to another video. As you can see, today we are installing the Cobb rear motor mount. Now, the reason for installing the Cobb rear motor mount is because the stock motor mount that comes on the Focus ST doesn't work as good as we need it to. So, in turn, we get a lot of wheel hop when we do pulls straight off the line.
Oh yeah.
Okay, so the Cobb motor mount has some thicker bushings and holes drilled into it, and uses a different type of aluminum that helps make everything stiffer, drastically helps reduce wheel hop. So I'll show you real quick how to do this. Just so you know, if you have the Cobb turbo back exhaust like me, and you don't have the downpipe bracket put back on, because with the Cobb downpipe you don't need to put the bracket back on, then this is going to be way easier. Because all you have to do is take the belly pan off that splitter at the bottom, and then just like the, I think it was like 4 or 5 bolts for the motor mount, and you're done. But either way, this is a quick install and shouldn't take more than maybe 20 minutes. So let's cut to the chase.
Thank you.
We're taking the lip spoiler and the belly pan thing off. Yeah. Honestly, we probably don't have to take the whole thing off, but it'll would make it a lot easier.
Oh, hold on. Over here.
Yeah. So we take these off, and then it's over by the cross member. I have one more over here. So I'm gonna remove the 4 bolts on the left side of it.
This is so much different than that stuff.
But he doesn't say which.
Where the fuck's your downpipe?
It's like up in there.
Over here.
Yeah, yeah, further back.
So am I taking it out? Put that back on.
I should just
put the nuts on.
Yeah.
For Caden had supports on his, because he didn't have a Cobb downpipe. He has the MVRP one.
Yeah.
Or, is it MVRP?
Yeah, MVRP. Yeah, that's one he has.
AG's car exhaust and MVRP downpipe.
Yeah. That was a thing that holds a downpipe?
Yeah, there used to be 2 bolts that went through in the piece and clamped to that.
Uh huh. Alright, so I didn't need any of that?
Nope. Well, you need those 2. You don't need the bolts either. You don't need those nuts on there either. But you can put them on just so you have them.
Yeah, I'll just leave them there. Yeah. I'll just save that for whatever reason.
Oh, that's the fun one back there. I forgot about that. Do me a favor.
Yeah.
So much easier to keep.
Yeah?
Because I didn't have those wrenches when I did it. The phone part's just getting it back on.
What was that?
The phone part's getting it back on. Like getting the wrench back on, getting this nut back on, and getting the wrench on.
And that just slides out then?
No, now you take this big bolt and this bolt. And I believe. Oh, and that big one, I think.
Uh huh.
Right, the motor mount goes, yeah, and this big one right here. That one I do last, was all the removed.
Oh, okay.
I think so. I need the same wrench in 15 too.
A 15?
Larger wrench,
please. You know, when I did the intercooler, I thought it was going to be like a pain in the ass.
Uh-huh.
To like take the bumper off and everything, and it's actually not that bad.
You want to get the other rubber mount?
Yeah. So really the motor mount's like that easy to do.
You just gotta make sure it's not fucking hot, which we didn't do in this case.
This thing?
Oh.
Oh, what is that?
Trash. Garbage? Not garbage.
Alright, fuck, that thing's hot. Jesus.
Yeah, the motor mount was hot.
No, the bracket that I just touched. From the shit in my hand. Oh, my back of my arm.
I guess Caden's on his way. I was like, we're almost done.
Alright. Look at the bolt adjusting the rubber over here.
This one?
This one.
Oh.
Because I almost jumped on you, so I know it's the right one. Bolt, this one. Oh, the new bolt.
It was like the most uneventful install video ever. This is actually like the oddly fastest thing to do.
Yeah, not bad.
I posted a picture that I was like here with the car lifted.
Yeah.
And this kid messages me, he goes, yo, you know anybody who does auto repairs? And I was like, oh, what do you need? Depending on what it is, I can do.
You're talking about me?
Huh?
Talking about me?
No, I'm just telling them in general. Only a couple bucks, I'll just so you know, we are gonna do a review of this car at some point in time. And it's gonna be great. Rode in it once, really liked it. It was actually a lot of fun. It was the furthest thing from stock. All right, so we just got done installing the rear motor mount. This is what the stock one looks like. It's just a big piece of aluminum with bushing. Doesn't have the holes drilled in it like you saw on the Cobb one. And immediately you will notice a difference. Initially, I thought it sounded like the car was gonna stall, but it's, you get more of like the engine sound. So I don't know how I feel about that, but maybe it'll just grow on me or I'll get used to it. You do feel it in the pedals a little bit more. But after doing a few pulls on the car, the power definitely is being like put down to the wheels better now, which is great. That's what we were doing this for. But just the sound has me feeling a little like iffy about the motor mount. Because I saw that it was advertised that it's supposed to reduce noise and wheel hop. But it seems like it's only reducing wheel hop. But the installation was quick and easy. It took me about 10-15 minutes to do. Or us, Manny and I, took 15 minutes to do. And this is like one of those like mods, like the motor mounts, like the prices are like a little iffy. They're not like, the prices aren't great, but they're not super expensive. But it's a good mod that, and you, cause you feel it instantly. But just the sound, I don't know, I feel Makes me feel like my car is overall just a little bit louder for some reason. But that's it. That's the install. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this video helps. Leave a comment below, like, and or subscribe if you like what you saw and if this was helpful to you. Until next time, peace out.